2. maja je u Libiji proglašen novi zakon o političkim strankama. Zbog toga Muhammed al-Magaraif redom obilazi gradove i sela, plemena i narode u Libiji. Sve je u funkciji predstojećih izbora. Intervju sa njim vodimo dan uoči kongresa njegove stranke.
What are the main political goals of this party?
Day after tomorrow will be a very historical day, not in history of the front, but also in the history of the country as a whole, I hope. Because the front, the National Front for the Salvation of Libya, is known throughout the country for its stand against Gaddafi for about 31 years. We struggled, we did all our utmost to see that Gaddafi is toppled, which is our first goal. The second goal is to establish, to contribute in establishing a constitutional, democratic, civil state after getting rid of Gaddafi.
Dialogue is the essence of democracy.
Definitely.
And you are preferring compromise in political life. What does it mean, concretely speaking, about Libya?
For the last 42 years, Gaddafi has confiscated all forms of dialogue, meetings, the rights of meeting, expressing views, expressing choices. And definitely, people have not been accustomed for open, responsible, free dialogue used for throughout the 42 years. They're used to getting orders from Gaddafi almost every day about what to be done for the country. And so people are not accustomed to have dialogue among themselves. And I think definitely, dialogue is the essence of democracy. Without dialogue, we cannot have democracy. And so, one of the things that early things that we have to all as leaders, we have to learn.
Danas su mnogi zabrinuti za budućnost Libije. Vrlo često se spominje i mogući raspad zemlje na tri ili više dijelova. Za Muhameda al-Magaraifa tu nema dileme. Jedinstvena Libija je jedini pravi put za ovu zemlju.
Once you said that unity of Libya is red line.
It is, definitely it is a red line. And if you have visited all parts of Libya through this revolution, throughout this revolution, you will discover that Libyan blood has been shed through in all parts of Libya, from different regions, from different, and you go to for example to the Amazigh area, you find many Libyans from different Amazigh, who are not Arabs. You'll find that many Libyans from other parts of Libya went there to fight, and then they died for and they were buried there. And the same thing. You go to different parts, other parts of Libya, you will find the Amazigh people have who are Berber and who went to different parts of Libya and fought for the liberation. And I think no one can have any doubt after this.
Thank you.
read the history of Libya since independence in 1951, throughout the first 18 years during the King's rule, I can assure you that we had a very democratic constitutional government. We had used to have elections every 4 years, and people used to participate in these elections. It's only after the arrival of Gaddafi that he abolished this system and prevented the creation of political parties. I'm sure with determination on our I think the Libyans believe now they have no choice but democracy. The alternative to democracy is dictatorship. We have no choice.
Kongres NFSL-a održavao se 8. i 9. maja u predgrađu Bengazija, u svadbenom centru nostalgičnog imena Venecije. Desetine stotina delegata iz cijele Libije stigli su na kongres sa velikim nadanjem. Organizatori su zadovoljni jer su predstavnici svih plemena i zajednica tu. Pored njih su predstavnici libijske dijaspore. Jedan od njih je Abdul Rahman, naš Nouš, financijski stručnjak koji živi u Sjedinjenim Američkim Državama, ali je porijeklom iz Libije.
Since I was a young kid living in Egypt. That dream is to see some political freedom in my country, Libya. I grew up in Egypt and then in the United States, and the reason why I was very much forced to leave my homeland here, Libya, is because of the political situation during the Gaddafi time, where my dad found out that, you know, there is no living under such a dictatorship. That's really eliminating Libya from progressing right now is the amount of corruption in the society that learned to live this way for the past 42 years. Okay? Today is the time to set the right standards based on scientific standards and based on modern standards for the financial system, for equality and opportunities, for education most importantly. I mean, today the college level, for the most part, college-level graduates today cannot really even read basic sentences. How can you build society based on that?
Hopes for us is this party, which is our party, will be the majority party in the coming parliament. Once we take the government over with this new party, this country will be transformed, entirely transformed. We shall make of Libya one of the best countries in the region.
Yeah. But how to find the best people for politics?
We know our people. We know who to take.
So, and what kind of political democracy you it best for Libya?
The political democracy is the parliamentarian democracy. This is what we want to have. The power of the majority of the people after election. What we want is democracy for the country and prosperity for the people.
Libijci su danas željni slobode, demokratije i pravde. Mnogi od njih misle da će im to obezbijediti upravo ova politička stranka na čijem su prvom kongresu izabrali upravo Muhameda al-Magaraifa za prvog predsjednika. Naredni mjeseci, čak sedmice, bit će presudni za budućnost ove zemlje. Mnogi su zabrinuti da će možda doći do odgađanja izbora najavljenih za 23. juni. Ali puno je veći broj onih koji na budućnost gledaju sa optimizmom. Tome pripada i sam Muhamed al-Magaraif, koji misli da će Libija vrlo brzo biti dio modernog i demokratskog svijeta.
We have a golden chance, a very unique chance to learn from others and to cooperate with others and to have a partnership for freedom, for progress, for democracy, for advancement. And I hope that we can reach this formula where we have a win-win situation. All Libyans win with the new situation that they have, and all our partners from from our region and from throughout the world, and including Bosnia. We can have a very, very unique and special relationship and partnership with Bosnia.
About that we will speak next time.
Ciao.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much indeed. Thank you so much.
كلمة واحدة هي المصداقية.